My students, today let us discuss another topic in complex variable 2, that is a part of your M4, complex analysis, probability and statistical methods. So Cauchy's integral formula is the topic that which we are going to discuss today. What is the Cauchy's integral formula states? The statement of the Cauchy's integral formula is, if f of z is analytic inside and on a simple closed curve C and A is any point within C, then f of k is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus k into dz. So try to understand the statement here. F of z is analytic inside a simple closed curve. So what is a simple closed curve? A curve which is a curve where the initial and the end points of a curve coincides. So such a curve is called as a simple closed curve. So in such simple closed curve, we have a point A, and f of z is analytic there. Once this condition is satisfied, then f of a becomes 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus a into dz. So this is the statement of a Cauchy's integral theorem. So now we need to prove this result. So in order to prove this result, since a is a point within c, that as we discussed just now in the statement, let us consider a circle keeping a as a center. And the circle which we are going to draw newly must be completely inserted in the simple closed curve C, one which we have taken. So then once this condition is satisfied, the function f of z by z minus a is analytic inside and on the boundary of an annular region between C and C1. The region which is between C and C1 is called as an annular region, and f of z is analytic there too. So whatever that we have considered now, in a geometrical way, if we represent, this is how it looks. So C1 is a simple closed curve. Within that, there is a point A. Keeping that point A as a center, we have drawn another circle C1 with R as a radius. So now when we look at this case, we remember a consequence of a Cauchy's theorem. So what is the consequence of a Cauchy's theorem says that integral over C f of z by z minus a, that is an integrand over a simple closed curve C, and C1 is another simple closed curve which is completely inserted in C where the integrand remains the same. The integration of the integrand over C and C1 remains the same. So that is integral over C f of z by z minus a dz, and integral over C1 f of z by z minus a into dz is same. They are equal. Call it as equation. The result you can take it as equation 1. So we have taken the curve C1, which is inserted completely in C, as a circle. So equation of a circle in a complex plane has been given by mod of z minus a is equal to r. So now z minus a, on removing the mod, it becomes r e to the power of I theta. And for the simplification purpose, we have taken z is equal to a plus r e to the power of I theta, and theta here varies between 0 to 2 pi, and differentiation of z is dz, which is I r into e to the power of I theta into d theta. So now substituting these simple substitutions in our equation 1, we get integral over c f of z by z minus a dz, and on the other side, over the curve, whatever the modifications we have done is with respect to C1. So only here in the second integral we are substituting it, and on simplifying, integral over C f of z by z minus a dz, we get it as integral 0 to 2 pi, that is the limits for theta, and f of a plus r e to the power of I theta into d theta. So here r is very small and we almost neglect it, or we can consider it as 0. So consequence of Cauchy's theorem is this. So here we get integral over c f of z by z minus a dz is equal to I under this f of a, and I has been taken outside, and on integrating we get theta and evaluating between the limit 0 and 2 pi, we get f of a into 2 pi I. So the result is, we want the result for f of a, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus a into dz. So that is what is Cauchy's integral formula. So that is for us in one particular case. So here let us get the generalized Cauchy's integral formula. So what is this? The statement of it is, if f of z is analytic inside and on a simple closed curve C, and if a is a point within C, then fn. So fn of a is equal to n factorial divided by 2 pi I into integral over c f of z by z minus a to the power of n plus 1 dz. So n here represents the fn, the number of times we have differentiated it. and which has got its own value. So the proof of which, the generalized Cauchy's integral formula, consider the Cauchy's integral formula as a result that we have proved f of a is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus a dz, and apply the Leibniz rule for the differentiation under the integral sign. So once we apply the Leibniz rule over the integration, the formula is this: 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z d by dou by dou a of 1 by z minus a into dz. So 1 by z minus a on integration we get minus 1 z minus a whole to the power of minus 2 into that, and simply 1 can be written as 1 factorial, and f of z by z minus a to the power of minus 2 taken into the denominator, so we get that minus 1 into minus 1 gives us plus 1. So on applying the Leibniz rule now, we get double dash 1 factorial 2 pi I f of z dou by dou by z minus a to the power of minus 2 dz, f double dash of a 1 factorial and 2 pi I. So this is what we get for the second differentiation and for the simplifying. And after differentiating n number of times, we get f nth derivative of n factorial by this, and f n of a denotes the nth derivative of f of z at z is equal to a. And this is about the Cauchy's integral formula in a particular case as well as in the generalized case. So this formula in the suitable cases, like however the problem has been asked us to find, so generalized formula can be used, or the original one, the first order formula also can be used wherever, however it is required. So thank you.